Khan Circle is one of the latest works of Muhammad Ahmed. It is a land art. Land art has been prevalent since the mid-20th century. Richard Long and Robert Smithson are considered authentic artists in the arena of land art.
هذا العمل طبعا اطلقت على دوائر خرفكان بالنسبه لكثير ياخذ خصوصيه المكان يعني فبالتالي خذ هذا الاسم هي عباره عن دوائر مثل ما شايفين في المنطقه صخريه تقريبا فحددتها في منطقه في دوائر وخذت الحصه اللي داخل خليت على الاطراف يعني سويت له على حدود الدائره فهي عمل جد بسيط يعمل على سطح الارض ويبقى يعني يدعو المشاهد للحضور الى هذا المكان لمشاهده هذا العمل لان مثل نوعيه الاعمال تقريبا ما نقدر احنا نذهب فيها الى الصاله اللهم الله عن طريق الفوتوغراف او الصور يعني
I do sometime interpret my work of art. Actually, a visual art, it's out of interpreting. You can explain it. I believe in the explanation more. Explaining is very simple. You can explain what this piece is made of. That's it. But in order, when I write about my work, you have to follow in the you have to fall something somehow fall down I can say falling down into interpretation so this interpretation is not actually dogma that it is not right totally it is kind of maybe right and not maybe not perfect yani so I do interpret some of my work. I give them erotic dimension. I give them political dimension. Some of them I give them sociological dimension. So those dimensions are again important. In order to interpretations is important in order to publish your visual art, especially my work, which to do with the contemporary art. Which are objects in order to publish it more in the society. So I have to go through the interpretation, not only depend on the explanation, because explanation is already there.
I have two experience in showing my arts. The first one, it was in the cafe shop in Sharm cafe. I showed some of my paintings there in a public for publics. That cafe was a public place and it's near to the sea and ordinary people come there even. But I try to find a relation between my painting and my works and the place that I loved. Now, if you go now, after years now, if you go, you will find the place has changed completely. It's not the same. So now, if I go there to visit the same place, the same cafe, I don't like it. But in that time, I like it. I liked the place. I liked how to show my painting there. It was very, and I have another experience by to show my paintings or my works by the car. I bought a new car, and I try to put all my paintings in my car, and I go for any place that I like, and I show it for public. To make an open exhibition for public. And I try to take photos of my exhibition for documentary. I don't care if there were many people came at that time or not, but I try to documentary my works by writing a diary or by taking photos for the exhibition. Just I try to find a relation between my works and nature, the environment, the place that I like to be there. Sometime now, because I'm living here in an open air in this village, in a countryside, where when I wake up I see everything, I see the sky, I feel with air, I see birds, everything. So all this my life here in this house remind me to continue to be in the environment, in nature. So there is no boundary between my works and my life and nature. So I have to be honest with my arts, in showing my arts, in showing even myself. So sometime if I exhibit in, or if I when I show in my works in the museum or in any place, so I feel like I'm not familiar with that place. I'm not familiar with those walls that I hang my painting or I put my artistic work there. So it's like you're showing something, what we call it, I mean, I try to be honest with my works. I show it in a true place that is suitable for my work. Not everywhere. I cannot show my works everywhere, in any place.